What's up, everybody? This is Eric Armstead, and welcome to another episode of Third and Long. Obviously, had a rough game Monday night and dropped our second game in a row. We're now 5-2, and definitely not a great feeling. And, you know, did I feel up to doing this show this week? Had to push myself a little bit because definitely upset, frustrated with, you know, the result in Monday night. And, you know, I promised that I would do this show good, bad, win, loss. Things going well, things not going well. And so we're going to do it. So welcome to another episode. And first, I want to start with playing in Minnesota. Obviously, we didn't win the game. You know, playing in Minnesota, you know, is definitely a tough environment and tough atmosphere to play in, you know, in their stadium. You know, I didn't feel like we got off to the best start of the game. And, you know, that really trickled down, you know, to the end of the game. But I don't think they shocked us. You know, first drive on defense, you know, we got off the field with the interception, a great play by Mooney. And, you know, things were going well. Then we had a turnover on offense and, you know, had to go back out there and, you know, I think that they just stayed on the field throughout the game a little too long, you know, for our liking. You know, at the end of the game, the result was 22 points, but it didn't feel that way throughout the game. It felt a little worse than that. You know, the end result, you know, we talk about our standard each week, 100 yards rushing, we did that. 17 points or less, we didn't do that. They had 22. And turnover battle, you know, we always want to take away three in the game, and we only got one turnover. So, you know, it wasn't to our standard, and it didn't really feel, you know, 22 points, not too bad, but defensively, it didn't really feel like that. It felt, you know, they only punted the ball one time, which means, you know, we weren't good on third down and getting off the field. And we played against, you know, a good quarterback who in the past we've been able to get after and, you know, kind of make not look so good. But, you know, Kirk Cousins is a great quarterback for a reason. And he definitely was hot on Monday night and had a great performance, you know, over 350 yards passing, which is tough to overcome. You know, we got off and didn't let it turn into touchdowns in a lot of situations, but just too much, you know, too many yards, too much, you know, time of possession, too much, you know, extended drives, not being great on third down. And, you know, those things are for a multitude of reasons. You know, you can look at up front, you know, obviously we believe it starts up front, and I'll be the first one to say that I didn't have my best game. And, you know, we got to do a better job of, you know, getting to Kirk and making him uncomfortable. And, you know, we talk about rushing coverage and guys on the back end tie-in as well too. And so, you know, holding up on the back end and giving us, you know, a little bit more time, and then us up front winning quicker to get to Kirk and being on, you know, how they're trying to block us. You know, they had their game plan of chippers and double teams and all the different looks they were throwing at us, and mixing in screen game a little bit, and you know, play max pro looks. And so, you know, us being on that and being on top of that, and then in the back end too, you know, being sticky in coverage and in our zones, whether we're playing man or zone, and you know, making Kirk take an extra hitch and, you know, obviously everyone could see that he was on fire. He was making, you know, quick decisions and getting the ball into, you know, the receiver's hands on in timing. And, you know, I talked about it, you know, a few weeks back of we were going to face, you know, great quarterbacks to get to where we want to get. And, you know, we have to make, you know, great quarterbacks not look so great when we play against us. And that wasn't the case Monday night. Kirk was on fire. Did a really good job on third down, didn't get off the field. And that's all about rushing coverage, you know. I believe they had a little over 70 yards rushing. So, you know, I talked about that before as well, too, of if they have 70 yards rushing, you know, I would have thought we would have won the game. But, you know, when it came down to third down, getting off the field, that's where we weren't great. And that's on all three levels of the defense, being tied in the back end and taking away his first reads, and then, you know, us getting home and getting pressure on him. So, like I said, positive thing. I mean, in a game of, you know, a football game can have typically around 60, 65 snaps. In a game of 60, 65 plays, you can take a cut up and, you know, really make the narrative of the game. If you want to make it look good, you can make it look good. If you want to make it look bad, you know, you can make it look bad. If you want to make it look terrible, you can. And, you know, throughout, you know, football is an amazing, incredible, unique sport because of all of everything going on, fans, 80,000 people, whatever it is, millions watching, tailgating, you know, both rosters, coaches, all these positions, you know, football teams, 53 guys going out there. It's all so big and exciting and a lot, but really football boils down to about three or four plays each game that are defining moments. And you never know what plays those are going to be. And that's why they say football is truly a game of inches. And you don't know what those plays are going to be, so you have to give it your all every play. And really, if you look at our game, both offensively and defensively, it boiled down once again to a few plays. You know, the Vikings offense only punted one time, which is bad on our part, but also our offense only punted one time. And so what that mean is, you know, the game really should have been a shootout. Both teams only punting one time and not really feeling like you can stop the other team from moving the ball, which is not a great feeling, but our offense was moving the ball effectively on them too. And then there's things that happen, you know, there's miscues, there's missed executions in the red zone versus, you know, on one specific play, holding up and keeping them to a field goal. You know, those type of plays throughout the game, our play before the half was a huge play in the game, you know, in a situation where, you know, they don't have much time left. And, you know, Coach Wilkes, who we stand behind, and, you know, I tell him to stand on, you know, what he believes in too, and what he's feeling and what he calls. You know, in that situation, he wished he would have had that call back because of the time on the clock, but there was other things that transpired in that game to lead to that call. Kirk was playing extremely well. We're trying to speed up his process, take away his, you know, first and second read and get some pressure on him. And we decided to heat him up. And, you know, we still had an opportunity to make a play on the ball You know, Mooney had a pick early in that game. Easily could have been two, and football's a game of inches. That's just sometimes how it goes, and they get a score before the half, which was, you know, a huge momentum shift. But the way we responded in the second half, you know, we held them to two field goals, you know, the rest of the game, and still wasn't as effective as we wanted to be on defense. But at the end of the day, it's 22 points. And so always room for improvement, always things we can get better at. And, you know, back to getting off to a slow start. And, you know, what is the message? You know, what is, when we come to the sideline, what is Coach Kasarik, our D-line coach, telling us? And, you know, what is the message at halftime? Obviously, we just had a huge play put on us. And, you know, really the message was, you know, these are the type of games that we're going to be in, and we have to find a way. And really how you find a way is not making things bigger than what they are, but getting back to your fundamentals and getting back to calming the waters, playing fundamentally sound, playing with technique. And that's how you get back to who you are. And so I think the second half, we did that, especially up front. That was our focus, was to play our technique, stop trying to, you know, because sometimes in games, you know, play a team can get a big play on you or make a play and you're like, what's going on, you know? But then when you watch the film after, it's like nothing's going on. That is football. Any given Sunday, no matter what the record is, no matter who's playing in the NFL, any team can get with any team on any given Sunday. And majority of games in this league, talk about all the time how it's hard to win in the NFL. Majority of the games in this league are one score games, which really boils down to a simple three or four plays that's going to win or lose the game. And you never know what plays those are going to be. And so in situations where things aren't starting off so great, the message to us was on the sideline, calm the waters, play, get back to playing fundamentally sound, playing technique, owning your box, owning your one-on-one, and, you know, stop trying to figure out what's going on and trying to, because that's how stuff can spiral, you know. Stuff, teams move the ball on you and you're like, dang, what's going on? Oh, now I feel like I gotta make an extreme drastic play and start doing things outside of, and no, it's like, calm down, move on to the next play, play with great technique, fundamentals, and that's how you get back to, you know, playing good defense and you know, trying to calm down what's going on. And so that was the message to us on the sideline, and that was the message at halftime. You know, he got a play, ball, weird play. Ball's in Mooney's hands, then the ball's in his hands, runs for a touchdown right before the half. It's like, man, what is going on? But what can you do? Calm the waters, get back to playing technique, playing fundamentally sound, everybody owning what they can control, which is their job. Do your job to the best of your ability, and play after play, that's your focus. If you've played in this league long enough, if you've been a fan long enough, you see how hard it is to win. I've been here for 9 years. I've seen some great seasons. I've seen some not so great seasons. There's ups and downs. Even in the seasons, there's every season comes with adversity and ups and downs. And it is truly hard to win in this league. And that's why winning is the cure to all your problems in the NFL, and losing can feel so depressing and feel like what is going on, the sky is falling, hit panic button. But really, if you haven't experienced the downside, if you haven't experienced losing or being humbled, if you haven't experienced the sucky part about football, and how losses affect everyone in the building, down to your families and your kids. No one's happy. And how wins is just the medicine to all of that. And everyone's happy and everyone is feeling good, from the players, the coaches, the organization, your families, everyone involved, the fans. And there's also a flip side to that. And as you can see, there is a yin and a yang in the NFL. In sports in general, there's a yin and a yang, professional sports. You know, it is amazing what professional sports does for not only us, but the fans and people who watch and tune in, and what it does for you guys as well, too. I'm sure, you know, it brings a lot of joy and it brings a lot of pain. I'm sure, you know, it comes with bragging rights, and it comes with, you know, having to hear a little bit of mess talk to you amongst your peers. You know, we have to deal with those things as well, too. And like I said, there's a yin and a yang. Obviously, you can see how fickle sometimes things can be. Starting off 5-0, greatest thing since sliced bread. Now you drop 2 in a row, 5-2, and things are the sky is falling. You guys suck. You guys are terrible. What is going on? And that's the nature of the business. But in all actuality, what we're going through right now is just the reality of the NFL. The reality of the NFL is it's hard to win. These games are close. If you don't execute in finite moments, if you don't execute on those 3 or 4 plays, those defining moments in the game, you won't win. And you'll have to take a loss, and you'll have to deal with everything that comes with it until you get another opportunity to go out there and change that feeling, get another taste of a win, and get that medicine back for your team and for your fan base, and have everybody feeling good again. And so I've been through that experience a plethora of times. This doesn't faze me. I've been through worse, a lot worse, in the NFL. Being 5-2 is great, actually, compared to a lot of the things that I've been through in the NFL. So always got to put things into perspective. That's the reality of the NFL. And what it boils down to is we have to find ways to win these games. And the great thing about it is we have more opportunities. There's a lot of football left to be played, a lot more of our season to become that team we want to become. Not all bad from the game. There's some positives to look at in the game. One being Christian McCaffrey setting an NFL record for most consecutive games with the touchdown. Man, that guy is special. Does it week in and week out. I talked about it before. He's definitely in the MVP conversation, MVP talks. He's definitely deserving of that. And he's just a truly phenomenal player. Game changer out there. The best running back in the NFL. And he's proven it week in and week out. So huge congratulations to him and that prestigious achievement. The new record holder for consecutive games with a touchdown was 16 games in a row. Man, that guy's been balling. Hard fought game. Wasn't the result we got. What's my mindset when going through a game like this, you're not having success early on, you know, it seems like things aren't going correctly. And really, my mindset in these situations are, what can I do? You know, my mindset in these situations are never to play the blame game, never to look at the people next to me like, man, what y'all gonna do? What's going on? I always look within in myself. What am I doing out there? How am I not being successful in helping us win this game? Where am I messing up at? And those are the things I really think about throughout the game is focusing on what I can do to help win, help do my job, help in my role, and you know, help try to change the outcome of the game. And that's my focus. It has been, and it always will be. It starts with myself first, and that's my mindset. Never to point the finger or play a blame game. Why is this going on? Why is that going on? What y'all doing? No, it's me. What are you doing? Why aren't you doing X, Y, and Z? You know, why aren't you willing this team to win? Why aren't you? So that's what I look at, and that's my mindset. And I think we have a bunch of guys on the team that have a similar mindset as well. The message post game, you know, it's very difficult, you know, to kind of sum up your thoughts like right after the game. I think that obviously we were very upset and frustrated in the locker room, and that was the sentiment around everyone. I think that Kyle always speaks to us after the game, and you know, everyone's just upset, but you always don't really know exactly why you lost the game until you have an opportunity to look at the film and see, you know, really what really went on. And so the sentiment was, we're extremely upset. We're pissed. We didn't get the job done. We weren't good enough. And that's what we're going to have to handle. And that's what we're going to have to deal with. You know, we didn't earn a win and we weren't good enough today. So we have to deal with everything that comes with it for the week until we get another opportunity to change that. And so that was the message, you know, and I think obviously the message changes once you get to watch the film, we get to come back to work and really see where we need to fix and clean up and why we lost. Cause a lot of times you don't really like know, like why did that play happen on offense, or why did they get those yards on us on defense? And so that's a sentiment, just frustration, and handling it the right way, handling your losses the right way until you have an opportunity to go and do something about it. So everyone's obviously frustrated and disappointed in the outcome. You put so much into this game, both individually as a team. We make so much sacrifices. We put our body on the line. We give our all, and you know, sometimes it doesn't go your way, and it doesn't result in a win, and it's very frustrating because we all care so much, and it affects our livelihood and you know everything we have going. You know, everything we have going is around football, really. Like, you know, even our whole lives, our families, everybody is tied into our football life, and it truly really affects everything. And so that's why I say getting a win is that medicine that cures all around your building, at home. And we have another opportunity against the Cincinnati Bengals on Sunday. And I know we're going to be excited and can't wait to try to get this taste out of our mouth. 2 weeks in a row is very frustrating. And we're definitely looking to get back on the field as soon as we can. Try to get a win heading into our bye week. Get some rest, regroup, refocus. You know, our main goal right now is to go into the bye week 6-2, you know, refocus, regroup, and then come back and go on this run. We have a gauntlet of tough games after this bye week. And, you know, as we start getting closer to, you know, November and December, you know, and those deciding games, we'll definitely be looking forward to getting to that part. But our main focus right now is getting a win against the Bengals, our whole focus had to shift immediately after the Vikings game because it's a short week. You know, we play Monday night and we play Sunday. So we've got five days and it's coming quick and really no time to really ponder too much longer, you know, on what happened against the Vikings. Our focus has to shift to being 1-0 versus the Bengals before we hit this bye week. And we have a great team coming into town. I think that we should no longer look at people's records. And, you know, I never look at records, but, you know, for you guys looking at people's records and, oh, this is going to be, you know, easy win or whatever. It's the NFL. I think that's something that we can learn is that this is the NFL. It's hard to win any given Sunday. The Cincinnati Bengals come into town 3-3. A team that, you know, quarterback was injured early on and still trying to find some identity. A team that's had a lot of success these past few years. Super talented team. Went to the Super Bowl 2 years ago, AFC Championship last year. So a team that, you know, really coming into the season is a Super Bowl contender and competing at a very high level. And, you know, they're 3-3 and looking to get their season back going and find out who they are and try to come into town and get a win versus us. And so, and they're coming off a bye week. And so it's going to be a challenge. You know, they have I think Joe Burrow is the highest paid player in our league, if I'm not mistaken. Talent at the wide receiver position, running back position. Defensively, they've been great throughout the years. Some mainstays on defense, Sam Hubbard, Trey Hendrickson. And so it's going to definitely be a game. You know, I think defensively our focus is to bounce back from our performance last week. One game doesn't define any player. One game doesn't define any team. One game doesn't define any position group. And so our focus is going to be to bounce back and do everything we can to enter that bye week 6-2. And, you know, we're looking to bounce back up front. We're looking to get a ton of pressure on Burrow, stop the run. You know, the Bengals rank and towards the bottom in rushing yards per game. And so we're looking to keep it that way versus us and, you know, try to make this team, you know, one-dimensional, like I said, each week and get after Burrow and make him uncomfortable and don't give him easy reads and throws and hit him, corral him, try to make it a type of game that, you know, he doesn't want to be a part of, really. And so we can get this taste out of our mouth because it doesn't feel great. You know, I've been playing football for the past 17 years and, you know, wins and losses, obviously a lot of wins and a lot of losses throughout those years. And one thing I do know is how big wins and losses are in this game of football and how, you know, getting a win is the cure that solves all those problems and how good it feels to go out there and battle with your brothers, lay it all on the line, do something that, you know, not a lot of people can do on earth and put yourself out there, lay it all on the line and fight and scratch and crawl to try to get a win and feel what that feels like, you know, for your team. And so That's what we'll be looking to do. Our focus is on these next 5 days. Pairing, getting ready, and ensuring that we're 6-2 heading into that bye week. And that's our main focus, and that's what we're going to go out there and get done. Another great thing about football is that we're all in this together. You know, no position can be successful without other positions. All our livelihoods are tied and wrapped in together. Wins, losses, how that feels for us, how that feels for everyone in our circles and extended, you know, and how it affects us. You know, everything is tied in. And it's the ultimate team sport. You can't do it without the brother next to you. And that's the great thing about it. That's why it's so fun. That's why it's so exciting. That's why you guys love to watch. Because you know, when we're out there, we're laying it all on the line for the man next to us to get that feeling and break through and have that rejoice in that medicine of a win that makes everything feel better. And so that's the great thing about football and the satisfaction you get from having success and doing that and everything that goes into that, everything you have to go through to get to a point where you can achieve that and play at this level and, you know, have success. It's a lot of sacrifice, a lot of hard work. It's a lot of pain and adversity you go through with your brothers out there. And that's what I think makes the sport so great. And that's what each and every week we are striving to do. That's a wrap for another episode of Third and Long. Thanks for watching and supporting. And this show is all about you guys. And so please let me know in the comments if there's anything you guys want me to discuss or show you or teach you about the game. We have some very exciting news coming soon about partnerships and new. We're going to start doing some interviews, and we're going to start having guests on the show, talking football, talking, you know, things off the field. So definitely stay tuned and see you on another episode of Third and Long.